Hi, this is part two of ultrasound of the breast. In part one, I showed you that by far the four most common causes of a mass or a lump in the breast are, first, an area with prominent dense glandular tissue, as seen in young women, pregnancy, breastfeeding, but sometimes also in older women, when most but not all of the glandular tissue is replaced by fat and there remains an area with more firm glandular tissue. Then, cysts. The most common cause of a lump in any age group and always benign except when there is a solid tumor within the cyst, and I will show you some examples. Then fibroadenomas, the most common benign tumor seen in young women age 15 to 25 years and uncommonly in women over 50. And finally, breast cancer, uncommonly seen in young women, but unfortunately it does occur sometimes, but mostly it is seen in women over 50. Now first we're going to look at more examples of breast cancer, then how to differentiate breast cancer that almost looks benign from a benign tumor, and finally how to diagnose and treat an abscess. And these are the subjects that we're going to discuss in the third video. Okay, first, many more breast cancers to become very familiar with how they look like. Now, what do we see? There is a hypoechoic lesion. The shape is irregular. There is an indistinct border. It is not sharp. And there is posterior shadowing and a hyperechoic halo. Here is the normal tissue and look where it stops. This is all abnormal tissue which forms the halo. Here another cancer. Irregular, halo, posterior shadowing. Most breast cancers look like this, very ugly. This woman didn't present with a lump in her breast, but the ultrasound was done because the mammogram showed a possible abnormality. And I show you this to make a point on tissue harmonic imaging. When a cancer is small and not so hypoechoic compared to the surrounding tissue, then it can be very difficult. Now there's a way to enhance differences between normal and abnormal tissue, and that is harmonics, which is short for tissue harmonic imaging. Many ultrasound machines have this possibility. It enhances the differences in contrast in the images. Tissue harmonic imaging off, tissue harmonic imaging on, off and on. Notice the tumor is more hypoechoic and the halo and the posterior shadowing are better seen. Now the downside is that if you only use tissue harmonic imaging, then sometimes normal structures may look abnormal. Better combine the two and then make up your mind. Here another ugly looking cancer. No need for tissue harmonic imaging. This is a spot diagnosis made in a split second. Just put a transducer on the palpable lesion and you have the diagnosis. Nothing else looks like this. Here another one. And you can imagine that this tumor presents as a lump because it is firm and it is surrounded by fat, which is soft. Here a very large cancer. Irregular shape, indistinct border, hyperechoic halo, posterior shadowing. Now, if this tumor only had an irregular shape, but no halo, no shadowing, no indistinct border, the diagnosis still would be cancer. Here a small lesion, doesn't look that ugly, but wait. It has an irregular shape, indistinct border, and a hyperechoic halo. This is breast cancer. Our next subject is how to differentiate breast cancer that almost looks benign from a benign tumor like fibroadenoma. Let's summarize the differences. First, the shape. A fibroadenoma is oval or sometimes round and may have a few lobules, but it has a regular shape. Breast cancer is mostly irregular in shape, but occasionally may be round or oval. In those cases, look for small irregularities. A fibroadenoma must have a well-circumscribed sharp border. And breast cancer is in most cases not circumscribed. It has an indistinct border, angular, microlobulated, spiculated. Now both lesions are hypoechoic, but a cancer may have a hyperechoic Halo. An oval fibroadenoma is always in line with the rest of the breast tissue. It has a horizontal orientation parallel to the skin. We call it wider than tall. When a carcinoma is oval in shape, it is usually not in line with the normal structures in the breast. The cancer infiltrates the normal structures and that is not parallel. So, it is frequently taller than wide. It has a more vertical orientation. A fibroadenoma may have some posterior enhancement, while a carcinoma may have posterior shadowing. And a fibroadenoma may have gross calcifications, although they may start as small calcifications, while a carcinoma may have very small calcifications in and outside the tumor, sometimes not visible on ultrasound, but only visible on a mammogram. And of course, fibroadenoma mostly seen in younger women and uncommonly over 50. Carcinoma mostly over 50, but unfortunately sometimes seen in younger women. In the article, you will find this table which summarizes it all. Now, here we see two tumors that at first impression look alike, but there are differences. The one on the left is hypoechoic, has a sharp border. Here one lobulation, a little bit of posterior enhancement and horizontal orientation. Must be a fibroadenoma. On the right, the lesion is also oval in shape, but has a more vertical orientation. It is taller than wide, and the border is indistinct, and there is some posterior shadowing. Must be a carcinoma. This woman felt a new small lump in her breast. Now, this may look like a fibroadenoma, but it's a little bit irregular, and she is 52 years of age. So, we did a biopsy and it turned out to be breast cancer. Not a big surprise. If something doesn't fit, then we have to do a biopsy to rule out cancer. Here, no problem. Vertical orientation, irregular, unsharp in a woman 74 years of age. This is breast cancer. This looks like a fibroadenoma, but because she was 47 years old, we did a biopsy and it turned out to be a carcinoma. These are small calcifications that we sometimes see in breast cancer. These calcifications are seen in a precursor of breast cancer called ductal carcinoma in situ. We have to assume that the invasive cancer developed within the area of ductal carcinoma in situ. Here, another irregular tumor, small calcifications, invasive cancer developed in an area of ductal carcinoma in situ. Here are two examples of gross calcifications in fibroadenomas. Let's talk about posterior shadowing. Here an irregular tumor, unsharp border halo and a posterior shadow. Must be breast cancer. And here another one. In this case, the cancer is so dense that we can only see the anterior contour and the rest is all shadowing. Sometimes with compression the tumor borders can be better seen, but sometimes, like in this case, this is not possible. Now, this may look like cancer with posterior shadowing, but it is not. This is a young woman with very painful breasts, and sometimes the glandular tissue can be so dense that you may have to give more compression to see the true nature of the lesion. And as you can see here, it's all just very dense, pronounced glandular tissue. It is normal. Now, could this be a fibroadenoma? Well, it's oval in shape, horizontal orientation, no posterior shadowing, but indistinct border, irregular contour. Must do a biopsy. This was a carcinoma. And another case. Must be a carcinoma. And another one. Okay. Next subject. Here we have a cystic lesion with something within the cyst. Now, this could be debris. And sometimes if you turn the patient, you can see it moving within the cyst. But that wasn't the case here. But it can also be an intracystic tumor, although not that common. Now, when we turn on the color Doppler, there are vessels within this structure. That means this is a solid lesion. It is a tumor, and it turned out to be a carcinoma. Even if we didn't see any vessel in the lesion, we still would have to do a puncture to find out if it was debris or solid tumor. Now, in this case, the fluid was aspirated and the tumor was biopsied. Here another carcinoma with a cystic component, and here the color Doppler image. Okay, last subject in this video is an abscess. Mostly, but not exclusively, seen in women who are breastfeeding and who have mastitis. Now, an abscess, just like a cyst, is a fluid collection, but it is filled with pus, which usually is hypoechoic with some debris-like stuff, and the wall is usually irregular, and the skin may be thickened, like in this case. This is the nipple, which is retracted, and the abscess is right behind the nipple. Notice the posterior enhancement, which also tells us that the content is some sort of fluid. Here, the aspiration of the pus, which is, by the way, the best treatment for an abscess. Okay, now in the next video, we're going to look at less common lesions like lipomas, fat necrosis, hamartomas, skin lesions that may look like breast tumors, breast implants, abnormality of the ribs, which also may sometimes simulate a breast abnormality, lesions in the axilla that are related to the breast, and breast problems in men. Hope to see you in the next video.